Hey everybody, welcome to another video of Microsoft Office tutorials. In this video, we are going to discuss how we can change 15 plus default settings of Microsoft Excel. So here we have written all those settings. I think these are 19 or 20 settings that we are going to change in this tutorial or on which we are going to work in this video. So let's move toward our tutorial. First default setting that we are going to change is Excel theme. How we can change theme in Microsoft Excel? To change this, we need to go to File. In File, we need to go to Options. In Options, in General Options, you can see here Office Theme. We have here option of Office Theme. And you can see here currently we are using white color theme. If you just come here, you will notice that here everything is white. Tab color is white. And here headers and headers of columns and rows are white. So let's try another color if we do have here. So we will just click on this small arrow and you can see here we have here three options. So let's try dark gray. So we have been selected dark gray. We will go for OK. And you can see here color has been changed from white to dark gray. Next is font and font size. How we can change default font and font size in Microsoft Excel? I think Excel has Calibri as default font and 11 is default font size in Microsoft Excel. So how we can change this? To change this, we need to go to File again, to Options. In Options, in General Options, you can see here use this as default font. So let's try another font. So maybe we can use body font and let's change size maybe to 20 and we will go for OK. But I think it will not directly start using this font. We have to restart Excel. So let's see, we will go for OK. Let's see what happens. And you can see here notification, please close and restart Microsoft Excel so that font changes can take effect. So means we need to restart Excel. But anyway, now we know how we can change this. We will move to next setting. Next is comment box window color. How we can change color of comment box window? To see this, we need to insert comment box here. So to insert comment box, we will right click, we will go here insert comment, and you can see here we have been inserted comment box here, but again we will right click and we need to select this show comments so that when we will make changes, we can see changes also. So we will just select this comment box, we will right click, we will go to format comment. And in this window, you need to come here in colors and lines. You can see here currently color of this comment box is yellow or light yellow color. So let's change into maybe red color. We will change into red color. We will go for OK. And you can see here now color has been changed. But I will show you one more thing. We will again right click. We will go to format comment. And you can see here line. Let's change color of line maybe into blue. Let's change style of line also. This is outline actually of this comment box. Let's use this style and let's make it a little bit bold and let's go for OK. And you can see here now outline color is also changed and style is also changed. Next is hide grid lines and headings. Actually these alphabets you can see here A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H and so on from left to right, and these numbers from top to bottom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, these are headings. And these thin lines from top to bottom, you can see here of a light gray color from top to bottom and left to right that represent cells. These are actually grid lines. So how we can hide these headings and these grid lines? To hide these, we need to go to View tab. In View tab, you can see here these boxes. When we will uncheck this grid line box, you can see here, you can notice that these grid lines have been hidden. When we will just uncheck this heading box, you can see here there is no alphabets, there are no numbers, mean these headings are also hidden. So we will just check these boxes and we will move to next setting. Next is change grid line color. As we discussed in our last setting that these thin lines from top to bottom and left to right, these are grid lines, and you can notice that color of these grid lines is currently light gray color. How we can change this color? To change this color, we need to go to File. In File, we need to go to Options. In Options, we need to go to Advanced Options. In Advanced Options, we will just go down. And in down there, you can see here this Display Options for this worksheet. and under this we have this option gridline color. So let's try to change into red color, because red is prominent and we will be easily able to see either it has been changed or no. So here I have been selected here red color. I will go for OK, and here we go. You can see here now gridline color is red. But I will also show you how to return same color, because maybe somebody will be worried how I can return same color. We will again go to file, options, same, advanced options, same, come down here, and in gridline color we will select automatic and we will go for OK. And you can see here now same color as before. Next is number of worksheets. How we can change number of worksheets in a newly opened Excel file? I think by default there is only one worksheet. Whenever we open new Excel file, there is only one sheet by default. So let's see how many number of worksheets we have in newly opened Excel file. We will go to file. In file we will go to new, blank worksheet, and you can see here we have by default there is only one worksheet whenever we open new Excel file. So just let's close this and let's try to change these number of worksheets. To change this, we will go to file. In file we will go to options. In options, in general options, you can see here include this many sheets. You can include here sheets up to 255. You can see here notification also 255. So let's try to insert maybe 5 worksheets. I have been inserted here 5. I will go for OK. So now let's try. We will go again to file. We will open new workbook, blank workbook, and you can see here now there are 5 worksheets. And now whenever we will open new workbook, let's try again, there will be 5 worksheets. Let's try again, file, new, blank workbook, and here we go. You can see here again there are 5 worksheets when we opened new workbook. Next is color worksheet tabs. You can see here these are worksheet tabs. This sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 2, these are worksheet tabs. And currently color is same as color of theme, that is light gray or dark gray, whatever. How we can change color of these tabs? So to change color of these tabs, we will just right click on this tab, any tab for which we want to change color. We will go here tab color, let's change into maybe red. And when we will unselect this, we can see color is red. So let's change it for this maybe into green. Right click, tab color, green, and you can see here when we will unselect, you can see here the color is green. Next is hide worksheet tabs. You can see here currently we can see all worksheet tabs. How we can hide this thing? To hide this, we will go to file, in file, options, in options, advanced options, and then we will come down here, and in down you can see here display options for this worksheet. We will just uncheck this box, show sheet tabs. We will just uncheck this box and we will go for OK. And you can see here now we cannot see these worksheet tabs. Again, to see this we will go to file, same thing, we will go to options, in options, advanced, and just same, come down here and just we will just check this box, show sheet tabs, and go OK. And you can see here we have here worksheet tabs. Now next setting is show or hide scroll bars. You can see here these are scroll bars on left side, and this is on down here. How we can hide these scroll bars? To hide this, we will go to file, in file, options, again advanced options, and we will go down there, and in down you can see here show horizontal scroll bar, uncheck, show vertical scroll bar, uncheck, and we will go for OK. And you can see here these are hidden. And to see, again we will go to file, options, and advanced, same thing, we will go down here and display options for this worksheet, check this box, horizontal scroll, check this box, vertical scroll bar, we will go for OK. And here we have now these scroll bars again. Next setting is expand formula bar. This is called formula bar actually. You can see here if we want to expand this, we will bring our cursor on this down line of this formula bar, and you can see here our cursor will change into two-sided arrow. We will just click by mouse and we'll drag it down whatever we want to expand. We will, let's say we want to expand till here, and you can see here this has been expanded, and just make it same size as it was before. We will just click on this small arrow and this is same size. If again this click on this small arrow, this will be same as we expanded this. Next is hiding ribbon and tabs. Actually, these things, home, insert, page layout, and so on, these are called tabs. And ribbon from this down line to this line, this whole area is called ribbon. How we can hide this ribbon and how we can hide these tabs? Let's start from ribbon. To hide ribbon, we will just click on this small arrow, and you can see here ribbon has been hidden. To hide these tabs, we will go here this small box, we will click on this and auto hide ribbon, and you can see here everything is hidden. To unhide this, you can see here are three small dots. We will click on this and you can see here we can see everything here. And when we will click on this small box, you can see here we have here three options. We can do anything whatever we want with this ribbon and these tabs. So we will show these ribbons and tabs. We will just click on this and you can see here now we can see everything. Next setting belongs to view of new worksheet. As we know, whenever we create new worksheet, the view is normal. As you can see here we have three types of view in Excel: normal view, page layout view, and page break preview. Currently, whenever we create new worksheet, it shows us normal view. How we can change this setting? To change this setting, we need to go to file, options. In options, under general options, you can see here default view of new worksheet. By default, it is normal view. Let's change into maybe page layout view. We will go for OK. And now when we will create new worksheet, it will show us page layout view. Next is indication color of error. What is indication color of error? Just let me show you. Here we have 100 in this cell, here we have 0. When we will divide 100 by 0, it will show error. But indication of error is, you can see here on this left top corner, you can see here this small green color. This is indication of error. How we can change this color? Currently you can see here this is green. How we can change this color? We will go to file. In file, we will go to options. In options, we will go to formulas. In formulas, you can see here indication error using this color. Currently it is green. We will change into red and we will go for OK. And you can see here currently it is red color. Let's try again. Make new error, 100 divided by again 0. And you can see here now this color is red. Before it was green. Next is in cell editing. What is in cell editing? In cell editing means that anybody can edit in cell by using mouse. When I will click two times on this cell, I can edit in this cell. So how we can disable this, that nobody will be able to edit cell by using mouse directly? To change this setting, we will go to file, to options, in options, advanced options, and here allow editing directly in cell. We will just uncheck this box, we will go for OK. And you can see here now I'm trying to press here, but I cannot change this. To change this, I need to use F2 button, or I need to go to formula bar and then I need to change this or edit this. Otherwise I cannot change this by using mouse directly. Next is hide formula bar. As we know, this is formula bar. How we can hide this? Very simple. We will go to view tab. And you can see here in view tab we have had this box, formula bar. We will just uncheck this box and you can see here there is no formula bar, it is hidden. To see this again, we will just check this box and you can see here now we have here formula bar. Next setting belongs to enter key. How enter key should work? As we know, by default when we press enter key, our selection goes down. As you can see here, when we press enter, our selection goes down. But we can also change this. How we can change this? Let's do this. We will go to file and options, in options, advanced, and you can see here after pressing enter, move selection, before by default it is down. So let's move this maybe up. We will go for OK. And now let's try this. We will press enter and it is going up. The next setting is direction of worksheet. As we know, direction of worksheet is from left to right. You can see these alphabets. These are moving from left to right. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and so on. Do you know we can also change this direction? How? Let me show you. We will go to file, then in options, again to advanced options. In advanced options, we will come down here And in display, you can see here default direction is left to right. We will change from left to right to right to left. Have been selected. We will go for OK. But it is not changed. No, it will not change. Whenever we will create, whenever we will add new sheet, view will be from right to left. So when we will go back to our old sheet, view will be same. But whenever we will add new sheets will be from right to left, right to left, right to left, and so on. Next setting belongs to Quick Access Toolbar. Change position of Quick Access Toolbar. This is actually Quick Access Toolbar in which we have these small icons. We can change location of this Quick Access Toolbar from here to down here. How we can do this? We will just right click on this and you can see here show Quick Access Toolbar below the ribbon. We will just select this and here we go. You can see here now we have here Quick Access Toolbar down here. Again we will right click on this if we want to take this on top. Again show Quick Access Toolbar above the ribbon. Select this and you can see this is again on top. Next is number of worksheets in history. We can also change number of worksheets that we can see in history. How we can change this? Again we will go to file, then in options we will go to advanced. In advanced we will come down here. In display you can see here show this number of recent workbooks. By default this is 25, but we can add up to 50. So let's add up to 50 and let's go to OK. And we can see where we can see these workbooks in history. In file, open, and you can see here these are recent workbooks that we have been used. So these are now up to 50 because we have been changed number from 25 to 50. Next setting is hide page break lines. As we know, sometimes when we make some setting for printing, these page break lines start showing here. I personally hate these lines because some people close their workbooks and open again to remove these page breaks. But how we can remove these page breaks from inside the Excel without closing our Excel workbook? To do this, we will go to file, then in options. From options, we will go to advanced options and then we will come down here. Inside display options for this worksheet, you can see this box. We will just uncheck this box, show page break lines. We will just uncheck this box and we will go to OK. And you can see here now there is no page break lines. Next and last default setting that we can change in Excel is auto recover time. This means what we want from Excel, that after how many minutes Excel save information from our workbook for auto recovery. To change this time, we need to go to file. In file, we need to go to options and then in save options. And you can see here save auto recover information every 10 minutes. By default, it is 10 minutes. You can increase or you can decrease this time. So friends, these are 15 plus or in total 21 default settings that you can change in Excel. If you like this video, don't forget to give thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe our channel and press bell icon button. Also share this knowledge with your friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.